You know, intuitively, the analysis of supply is very much like the analysis of demand. Really, it's just looking at the flip side of the same coin. Let's look back at the key points of demand and then turn those concepts around to apply them to the seller instead of the buyer. Remember the law of demand? Buyers like low prices and dislike high prices, other things being equal? Well, what would a law of supply look like? Think about it. What do sellers like better, low prices or high prices? Sellers prefer higher prices. That is when they're happier to provide their product or service to the market. So the law of supply might be something like, more of a good will be provided the higher its price, less will be provided the lower its price, ceteris paribus. This law of supply makes perfect sense, saying that there is a direct relationship between price and quantity supplied. Of course, at lower prices, suppliers are either unable, they can't cover their costs, or unwilling, not enough profit motive, to provide much product. But at higher prices, the suppliers make a lot more profit, other things remaining equal, and are much happier to provide the product to the market. Okay, think back to demand again. What factors or variables affect willingness to purchase? Quantity demanded is affected by product price, price of substitutes, price of complements, income, tastes, age, weather, and so on. Well, guess what? Suppliers' decisions are affected by much more than the price tag, too. Like what? Well, good question. What determines a supplier's willingness or ability to provide the product to the market? Price of the product, certainly, but more important is profitability, which is determined not only by product price, but also by cost of production, such as wages or cost of labor, rent or cost of capital, cost of raw materials or natural resources. What about other costs besides the resources? Taxes, paperwork, licensing? In some businesses, you have to pass exams or be subject to periodic audit or accreditation. These are all costs. What about variables that affect your ability to produce? Worker strikes, natural disasters, shipping disruptions. Inability to get your resources results in an inability to produce, decreasing the amount provided to the market. On the other hand, better technology or worker productivity would be examples of variables that would enhance production, making more product available. What else? Expectations affect supply. Heck, even weather affects supply. Ultimately, quantity supplied is a function of all these things. Price, wages, taxes, technology, weather. Just remember, I only like to look at two things at any given time, so that I can draw the relationship, in this case, price and quantity supplied. Going back to our housing example, at a price of $100 per square foot, and considering wages for carpenters, roofers, electricians, plumbers, lumber, copper, permits and fees, expectations of home sales, etc., quantity supplied, one, will be provided. But if price goes to $200 per square foot, all else staying the same, more houses will be provided. There are an infinite number of other prices and associated quantities supplied, so the supply line is the collection of all price-quantity supplied combinations. Just as with demand, a change in price will not change the supply, but rather move along the supply curve, resulting in a change in the quantity supplied. Changing anything other than the product price will alter the underlying supply. For example, what if the government imposes a higher minimum wage? As wage increases from W-1 to W-2, the quantity demanded of labor, since the employer demands or purchases some amount of labor, decreases from L-1 to L-2. With less labor to work with, the supply of the end product decreases. Any cost increase makes business less profitable, which is a disincentive to produce. What would happen if costs fall? For example, if business taxes decrease or if technology gets cheaper? The bottom line is that you need to pay careful attention to the difference between a change in supply and a change in quantity supplied. Next time, equilibrium.